Hi, I'm Mano Marks with the Maps Developer Relations team here in at Google in Mountain View. I am going to talk to you today about the Google Maps SDK for iOS and specifically about some new marker management features that we added to the SDK in version 1.2. So in version 1.1, when you had a map, when you wanted to add a marker, you added the marker from the map object. Let's take a look at what that code actually looks like. You can see here in older versions, 1.1 and before, you would create a GMS marker options object and create a CL location coordinate object, and then with map view, you would call add marker with options and give it the options object. We don't do that anymore. The reason that we don't do that anymore is because we wanted to give you a lot more control over marker objects. Let's take a look at what code looks like today. So you can see here I've got two arrays, two mutable arrays. And what I'm doing is I'm just adding random markers into those arrays. And you'll see what I'm doing is I'm creating the marker object, GMS marker object, separate from the map. What this allows you to do is then assign the marker to any map object that you want to be that you want to use in your application. It also allows you to do interesting things like create your own marker management tools and techniques. You can create your own quad trees or clustering algorithms or anything that you want, which wasn't previously easy to do with the Google Maps SDK. So you see here each marker that I'm adding 10 markers, and every other marker I'm making it green. And you'll see here we also added this add marker. You could add colors to your marker using the marker image with color. And so what that looks like here is you see I have red and green markers being added to the map. And this allows me to do things like walk through one or the other of the arrays and just turn on or off each marker by simply assigning the map to nil. So when you want to turn on when you want to assign a marker to a map, you just say marker.map equals this particular map view, or you assign it to nil. The marker object still exists. It's still something that's around for you to use, and you can assign it back to the marker to the map when you want to. So you'll see here that allows us to do things like this. I've got this simple one here. Here I can turn off all the markers by simply assigning them map nil. I could turn on all the red or I could turn on all the green because they're in separate arrays. So pretty simple but powerful change that gives you a lot more control over how you manage markers in the iOS SDK. So that's it. That's your shortcut for today. So thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next week.